Hello, welcome back to Atom RPG, and right now we are in the Luther base and we are finishing the mission with Maxim. As you can see, he is leading a nice and peaceful life on the dirty floor, on a mattress. And we also have to speak with the former so we can clear the ruins that block our path to the Institute. So let's finish the quest first. Glad to be of service. I guess nothing changes in her dialogue. Well, she still has biscuits and a knife to sell us, so what? I guess that's fine for now. Also, let's speak to Maxim. He should give us a reward. By the way, I love the flashlight helmets. The light is so natural. It almost feels like a horror game. And the sound effects are really good. Anyway, let's speak with him. Let's have a chat. What will you do now that you're free? Start living off the dirt? Yeah, go back to farming. This is not a good place for you. I saw someone walk into that tunnel. Okay, that was a trap. It was a big trap. Their dad came over, gave me a once over look at his theft. Okay. So he almost got married. And that's the scary part. So he was more afraid of getting married than getting eaten alive by the dogs. What is this place? Yeah, the woodpecker. Oh. So. Oh, so maybe he's trying to destroy the stalkers or something like that. So let's see the rewards. The rewards are pretty nice. I mean, you get 300 rubles, which is nothing but stimulants, food, diesel for some weird reason, and some sniper ammo, which is enough for me. Now let's speak with the foreman. I think you will also need some money, but we're covered on that part. I mean, 44,000 rubles is enough. I wish I'd brought my pistol with me, but hey, this is life. I believe I have some work for you. Okay, I think he knows about this place. Okay, it's about reputation for them. Let's call the man. Sure. Lazy bones, you drunk? Thank you, guys. So yeah, they're friends, but they speak... Maybe it's a Russian thing, I don't know. Or maybe it's just the apocalypse. The almost apocalypse, because not all the people were killed. Will you come here? No. Oh, he'll stay here in case he needs to give our money back. Well, that's customer support right here. I'm going. So let's see. I also have to go to the sky station. But that's a long way. So let's have to get a briefcase. Sounds like fun. Let's do it. Well, so far I've been having a lot of fun with the game, and I also found the Ushanka head because I need more survival. So right now, in case you're wondering, I'm a guy wearing a combat armor with a dragon nose, a Ushanka and a clown nose. Yeah, probably I look very scary. To drunk people or something, I don't know. The combat helmet is nice, but I think it's more about the utility of the items. Maybe I should wear it. I don't know. It seems that I get attacked less and less if I use it, so why not? So yeah, I'll be definitely starting a new game and then I'll just have to maximize the efficiency of my characters and actually get Alexander. Besides, if you start the game right now, you have to make a different build because things have changed. Okay, I have to enter battle with the rats again. But sometimes, as you can see, depending on your survival skill, you get put very, very close to the exit. And this only started happening after I started wearing the Ushanka hat, so it's definitely tied to your survival skill. And yeah, the slow walk through the metro tunnels, which is amazing. I love this feeling. By the way, the map is pretty big. As you can see, we have three locations, four. 5, 6, 7. Come on, again with the rats. Lucky for the rats, it's more expensive to use my guns than to actually kill them, so I'll just have to run away. That was a burst. Use small... maybe they should add an option for you, your companions to use small bursts. Or actually, single shot instead of automatic. On the other hand, it's a very good way to earn a lot of experience. So you could technically just spend your time in the tunnels to hunt rats. But on the other hand, you might find demons, and the demons will kill you very fast if you are not well prepared, or well equipped, or have a high level. As you can see, I'm level 20. Almost 21. So they should have cleared the rubble so we can enter the Institute. As a small note, you can also find the Institute on the overworld. So if you go outside the metro and travel... What are those? Oh, the spikes are creating those weird shadows. The spikes on my armor are creating those weird shadows. Well, I guess the light doesn't know how to react to spikes. Okay, let's end this. The death animations are also very nice. Another 150 experience, which is nice. And also, I think the Zulpar is getting a little too fat. He's been eating so many dead rats. It almost feels like a shame to waste all that meat. Maybe they should add an option if you feed Zulpar meat and his full HP, he should gain a little experience or something, because such a shame to waste all that nice meat. Red burgers. So right now the tunnel should be cleared. I mean, this part was... Yeah, this is the part that was full of rubble. They did their job. It was worth it. By the way, there are no enemies in here. And I've already used this. This was a nice bit of experience with my technology skill. And since I don't need empty glasses in my pockets, let's go to the Institute. I have a feeling we'll encounter something very dangerous in here. Maybe I should wear the combat helmet, you know, in case something hits my head very strong. Like a bullet or, I don't know, some mutated rat. Thinking about mutated rats, I think they infiltrated this compound too. Okay, I'll still wear my clown nose, and as you can see, this gives you the same effect as a Red X. So your radiation resistance is pretty high. Well, now the spikes are working nicely with the shadow. So, let's see what's happening in here. We have a leg. And an old boot. What? Well, I guess you tried to escape the elevator. Let's see, the map is big. Oh, it's one of those big maps. I hope I don't fight just rats in here. The big Institute bunker. Okay, so I guess this will be a 30-minute episode then. This reminds me of the bunker in the mountain. By the way, the story says that soldiers came through the Institute. They blew up the place. I mean the tunnels behind them, so they wouldn't get followed and they killed all the rats. Maybe we won't encounter many rats. And this leads to... nowhere. Oh, so this is the slide that you can... I understand now. I understand what's happening in here. So we can go up, but can we go down? We instantly got radiated as soon as we went out for the surface. So I guess this is an alternative route. If you don't want to go through the tunnels, you can just go on the overworld map. Climb, throw a stone, listen, Smell the air. Fetish decay. So yeah, if you don't want to go through the metro and pay all those rubles and stuff like that, you can just come through the overworld map and do it like this. So I was already here and I did all the things I had to do. Oh yeah, I'm sick. Now let's see. Did this reset? No, I don't think this reset. So yeah, we basically explored this place in my first playthrough of the game. And by that I mean when the game came out. So I don't think we'll find anything in here. Let's see, I need to get... Okay, so I need to go to the surface. I just wanted to check out this place because it's not a part of my mission, but I just wanted to see if something changed. Anyway, this place is looted, so don't worry. There is not a single stone that hasn't been turned in here. Right now I'm just seeing if there is any change to that. There should be some junk around here. Oh, I did such a good job, I cleaned up everything, right? Yeah, I did. I cleaned up the house. So again, this was part of the story, so if you play the game right now, you start over or you start, or maybe you buy the game right now, the gameplay experience will be totally different from what you first played. I mean, it's still the same game, but different mechanics, different combat, different stuff. Also better dialogue, more options and stuff like that. Let's see. Let's take a radiation pill, so it's 100%. And now let's go on the outside and go to the hospital, the ruins of the hospital. Yeah, so this is kind of like a shortcut in case you want to do the metro thing. And not, you know, go through the wasteland getting attacked by... Well, I suppose it's the same thing. Either you get attacked by rats or you get attacked by the ghouls or the creatures. Ah yes, the beautiful wasteland. By the way, there is a way you can go out through here, through the tunnels. I don't remember exactly how, but you can exit through here. But I don't recommend doing that because this is a radioactive poison cloud, dust cloud. So when I did that, I just came up here and I was immediately radiated. So again, it's kind of a bad idea to do it like that. Is this shining or something? Okay, let's fight some more monsters, because I love them. And this is a lot of them. Well, good thing I'm wearing my helmet. Oh, he... I dropped my weapon? You bastards, how could you do it? Well, I suppose I should have used the AK. Yeah, let's use it, but as a backup weapon. I don't think a single bullet will kill them, so let's go for a headshot. And now the fun part begins. As you can see, they're attacking me because I have lower dodge chance. And they also have the armor perks, which means they'll basically only attack me most of the time. So having minus to your dodge is like having, I don't know, a hate or a higher threat level than the others. It's hard to explain. If you play the other games, this is basically like taunt. Yeah, I need to bullets too. Do you kill them? Don't worry, they only attack me, but... Did I get a damage increase? Because right now my armor is not protecting me at all. Stop feasting on my friends, you savages. That was better. Hey, what did you do? So yeah, in case you're wondering, the savages are a lot more... I don't know, bitey? They have better teeth or something. They improve their oral hygiene in the meantime. So now, they can actually bite off your head or something. Yeah, playing the game developers, not me. So yeah, these guys are very dangerous right now. Ah, he's good. Whew, those creatures now deal a lot of damage. And again, I was wearing the good stuff. Also I have the perk, that means my damage threshold is very high and also my damage resistance is 50% almost. And this little thingy right here moves, but it usually starts somewhere around the old hospital. Okay, so I have to take a detour. Actually, this is very nice. And this is where the missile fell, I think. But you can go to the playground even if you don't have the mission. So yeah, they added a lot of location, plus the whole metro system. Get ready to kill more rats, I suppose. Well, at least they have some vegetation around here. Oh, I wanted to loot the ambulances, but I think they are static objects. Okay, nothing there. My guys are using their flashlights to see in the daytime. Nothing here, so let's go into the hospital. I don't think we'll have any problems in here, but you never know. Yeah, so my companions have more dodge than me. As you can see, their dodge is perfectly fine because they have the armor perks. The shield one is not so good. Zulbar has 31 dodge, so that means you'll rarely get attacked. So that's why he keeps out of trouble anyway. Oh, I think this creature wants to be killed. By the way, what are these guys eating here? Or they just don't eat food? Maybe they should develop the story of these creatures more, because there are a lot of them and I don't think they eat normal food. That was so satisfying. They fly all over the place. And I think they should have different stats. Not all of them should have the same stats. You know, maybe turn them into zombies like a fat demon or a fast demon or a muscular one. Let me guess, they haven't entered combat, right? That's bad. Anyway, let's try to kill them alone. But I'm wasting precious ammo. Yeah, they deal a lot of damage. 16 HP? Yeah, they can bite off your head right now. That's what I was saying. Shot in the eyes and didn't die. Well, that was silly. Okay, this time I will enter with my companions. Easy now, easy. So the demons were actually an easier fight than these guys because I guess they still have some problems programming the enemy's behavior. Okay, now they should start coming for me. Good job, guys, you killed an enemy. Weird, they don't get killed if you shoot them in the eyes all the time. Nice job, mopping them up. Okay, that was a little overkill. Little bad. Hey. You can come back now, it's safe. I think there is also a mod that will turn Zulbar into some kind of a demon or something. I saw it on the workshop, in case you want a better... If you want a better Zulbar, or at least a dog that fights, I think you can use that mod. But I haven't tested it out, I just saw... it. So we have to go underground. Of course you have to go underground, why not? Advices from the toilet. Recipe. Quality knuckle duster. What? Made a dear mistake. Finally I'm sober and my mind is clear. I either freaky toilet or she named Cruel. What? Oh, so this is T. Cruel Esquire, manhole mask. Anonymous beating with a quality knuckle duster made of a Svichatka and scrapped filled pile down with a brick? E. Cruel Esquire, Manhole Master, okay. That's his title, so he has a title, Manhole Master. Just look at my reflection. You can even see the clown nose. Well, this is quality gameplay right here, see? Oh, I hope I can make that into a thumbnail. That's funny for some reason.
Oh,